subscription claims and saying thank you for joining me.
It's my pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Reddit is in a lot of trouble if they're, you know, faking subscriptions. What's the penalty for something like this? Or is Reddit just done?
That's a great question. Listen, this isn't the first time Rite Aid's been in hot water. Just last year in August, Rite Aid settled a $30 million lawsuit with the West Virginia Attorney General's Office, accusing it of oversupplying the opioid supply chain. Especially, and we know, look, West Virginia, Kentucky, they're some of the hardest hit states out there when it comes to opioid fatalities. So this isn't new to Rite Aid. They shouldn't be surprised. What's surprising here, though, is the role that corporate Rite Aid played towards its rank and file pharmacists, literally telling pharmacists to delete messages that identify prescribers to be acting outside of the scope of medicine, acting outside of the scope of opioid prescription, and allowing for pharmacists to leave notes that would warn other pharmacists to bad prescription behavior. How corporate Rite Aid got involved in this is beyond me, but it definitely goes beyond the pale on this one.
Well, as you know, America has a fentanyl problem, but this time it isn't about the doctors. This one is about the pharmacy. So, how is this one different from everything that we've seen before in the past?
Well, this one's interesting. So, this is a civil lawsuit called the False Claims Act, really dating back to the days of Abraham Lincoln, which was intended to protect America from claims that were falsified to the
fentanyl. Guess what? Power. Same power the Department of Veterans to pay for whatever drugs they're prescribing to the military.
Additionally, kids are getting mad at the public and complaining about them wanting to dial back Medicare coverage for millions of Americans. What is it most of the things? This has been found to be misleading, as top Republicans such as House Speaker Kevin McCarthy have said such actions are not on the table.
MAGA reported that there were as many as 100 million people with pre-existing conditions would lose their protection. That's a fact. And folks, look, affordable health care is also working Americans have access to preventative care, like cancer screening. Mega Republicans put that at risk as well.
Has more than 100 million users in the U.S. A TikTok spokesperson says that the Committee on Foreign Investment in the United States has demanded that the Chinese owners of the app sell their shares. According to the journal, 60% of ByteDance shares are owned by global investors, 20% by employees, and 20% by its founders. TikTok, which rejects the spying allegations, says it has spent more than $1.5 billion on rigorous data security efforts. On Wednesday, it added the best way to address concerns about national security is with the transparent U.S.-based protection of U.S. user data and systems, with robust third-party monitoring, vetting, and verification. Last week, the White House backed a bill that gives it new powers to ban TikTok and other foreign-based technologies if they pose a national security threat. President Donald Trump tried to ban TikTok in 2020, but was blocked by the courts. Another hurdle would be that any U.S. company buying TikTok would also require the approval of the
chair. As Neil W. McCabe spoke to a senior Trump campaign advisor about
over COVID-19.
Or his outlook on news. Today's Thursday, March 16th. This edition of What America News starts right now. Says the U.S. should fly more drones over the Black Sea. During an interview with CBS Today, the vice chairman of the Senate Intelligence Committee said Russia is testing the U.S.'s boundaries. Yet in Russia, downing of a U.S. drone was no accident, but instead, Moscow is testing the Biden administration's limits. Rubio suggested the U.S. fly more surveillance drones over the Black Sea and have them escorting U.S. fighter jets.
These are unarmed platforms to generally get out there for reconnaissance, to see what's happening in the ocean, to have a situational awareness of what's going on in the area, totally according to international law. And so I think we should fly more of them. We shouldn't stop flying them. And in many cases, we should be prepared to scramble jets and respond if they are threatened by Russian aircraft.
Rubio said the drone was flying in international airspace, which Russia tried to close off. He added surveillance drones flying